Will the last word ever spoken be wise? Will the last word ever spoken be wise?
Good evening.
Someone's lost the plan.
Tonight we're going to talk about a subject which you might not think is controversial, but when I pick it apart, you'll realise it is quite controversial.
John Lennon.
Because, for example, look at that album, The Beatles' Number 1s. There's a mixture of British and American singles that got to number 1 put together. It's a bit random. I don't think it works very well. But supposing they did the same for the Beatles' solo careers. Now, bear in mind, you've got 27 songs
on the Beatles' one
in Britain or America. Now, if you did the same for the solo careers, you've got 20. Altogether 24, if you want to count a B-side from Elton John's song and three charity songs, which Paul either sang a sentence in or... you couldn't even hear Paul's contribution. So realistically speaking, 20 songs made it to number one by the Beatles. You know, there's a couple of, there's a duet or so on there, and two duets, and, you know, all kinds of bits and bobs.
Just altogether pointless.
But put it this way, in 7 years, we got 27 number ones to put on the one album. And in 50 years, we've got, realistically speaking, 20 songs that hit number one by the Beatles. That's not very good, considering they were the greatest band in the whole world. This shows how fragmented and unimportant they had become, when they could have had the world at their feet.
Styles
of living and egos going backwards and forwards, you know, they all failed. Really, and we won't see another number one by any Beatle. If we do, it'll be when one of them dies, and it'll just be one of the big hits shoots up to the top of the charts. Don't know what it'll be for Paul. It's a difficult one, but something should get to number one. Probably might even be Yesterday. I mean, that's how unlucky he is. That's how much his solo career will amount to, I expect. My sweet lord, a colossal hit at the time, but you know, House, it's still on the gold playlist, you know, the old the radio stations that play all the hits from the past. It still turns up there, but you know, it's not, I don't think it's seen as such a big song as when it came out. You know, I think it's the plagiarism that's put a halt to all that. So sorry about that, George. I just don't think it's a worthy song. I'm sorry. Uncle Albert, Admiral Halsey. Who's heard of this song nowadays? I mean, in the street, who's heard of this song? Nobody. It is bloody awful. I don't know how it got the number one, but it did. In America. That's Americans for you. My Love. Now, this is actually a beautiful song. And, all right, it's a bit slushy. It's a bit OTT. But, you know... give it a break. Listen to it. Beautiful guitar solo. Give me love, give me peace on earth. Another forgotten track. Got to number one in America. It's not known these days. It's a nice tune. Did it deserve to get to number one? Probably not, but... Photograph, a lot of people, oh, I love Photograph, I love Photograph. People just say I love Photograph. They don't listen to it, though. And it's quite painful to listen to Ringo singing a song which is totally unsuited to him. Totally unsuited. I've never listened to it since the early 80s, I don't think. I just find it a hard song to get through.
It's a 10 out of 10.
I guess there's just two kinds of people, Miss Sandstone. My kind of people and assholes. It's rather obvious which category you fit into. Have a nice day.
You're 16. You're beautiful. And you're mine. Oh, mine.
You're 16. Now, Ringo did a cover, and it's You're 16, old 50s tune. But it's a better version than the original. A complete accident, I should imagine, but it still works. It works. My nan bought me this single in about 1979. She just went down to the Wendy house, come back. I've got you something. It's Ringo. You like the Beatles, don't you? Oh, thanks, Nan. Really pleased with it. Really pleased with it. I think it cost her about 10p, 5p. Anyway, yeah, good song. On the Run. What more can I say? It's a classic, but how much longer will it remain a classic? That's the thing. How much longer? It's still on the playlists. It's got that, but like I said, it's teetering a little bit, and McCartney, I don't think he does sing it anymore, but the last time I bloody heard him sing it, my God, somebody lock the box, eh? Bang the nails in the coffin, stop him singing it. Gets you through the night. I hate this song. I really do. The more I hear it, the more I hate it. You know, and this was John's only number one when he was alive. The only one. I mean, it is bloody awful. I just don't like it. It's too much saxophone. There's not enough lyrics. It's as if, I don't know. I can't work it out. It never deserved to be at number one, that's for sure. You know, and it's amazing how you've got songs like Happy Christmas, Instant Karma, and Imagine, they didn't get the number one. It's amazing. They didn't. I don't think Imagine ever got number one in America. It's incredible, isn't it? So this one is not officially one of the solo Beatles. It's a song by Elton John got to number one called Philadelphia Freedom. John had just done his Madison Gardens thing with Elton, and he's on the B side. So of course, as the single got to number one, I'm including it, but it's cheating a little bit. So this is the first dubious record we're coming across. Not very well sung, but I mean, it was live. It was, you know, I mean, it must have been an exciting time. It's a shame there's no footage of it, but there you go. As a song, it's not a number one in its own right, is it, really? Let's face it. Listen to what the man said. Oh, do you know what? There's another one I haven't listened to for so many years, maybe 20 years. It's just, I liked it for all of about 10 minutes, playing it over and over, and I really enjoyed it. And then, you know, it's like the actual album, Venus and Mars. That's the one you see in all the second-hand record shops. Back in the 80s it was, you know, it was everywhere. I picked my copy up for about £1, I think. And it was good condition. It's just, you know, people bought a lot of albums back in the 70s, but when they got tired of them, they just give them away because they thought, I'm never going to listen to that again. Venus and Mars was one of them albums. Listen to what the man said as a single from that album. suffered exactly the same fate. You like it for 5 minutes and then you stop it. Oh, don't. I never want to fucking hear that song again. And it's the way it stayed for me. It is. There you go. Silly Love Song, a beautiful song, a worthy track to get the number one, if you like.
Smiles in the sunshine and tears in the rain.
Malachi Tyre, well, it very, very much deserved to get to number one. It is very sad how it's totally forgotten now. This should have been bigger than Imagine in a lot of people's consciousnesses. But it is totally forgotten. It was, and in a way still is, the biggest selling single in Britain ever. But nobody knows. Nobody's heard of it. You know, it is amazing. Amazing. But I think it's great.
There is no end to what we can do together. Together.
With a little love. Now, I don't know, this is brilliant, this song. I love it. And although I've reassessed my love for London Town, a little bit now, and you know I'm going to be a bit more critical when I actually review it, I still think this is a fantastic song. Yeah, it's wishy-washy, it's everything that people hated Wings for, but you know that I liked it a lot, and there was nothing wrong. You don't have to go around saying I want to beat up the Queen or shoot a policeman in your song. Sometimes it's all just hello everybody, what a lovely morning. It doesn't hurt, does it?
You wanna love to last forever. One that will never fade away. I wanna help you with...
Coming up live in Glasgow. No, I don't think this... I mean, even if it was the original studio version, it still wouldn't be number one. I don't know how it got to number one. It must have just been a little gap and Paul McCartney managed to get in there, but I don't like it. It's good on the McCartney album, I think, but releasing it as a single, obviously a good move on his part, but I don't know how it got to number one. I think it was the video that done it, because the song's just a bit naff really, isn't it? Like starting over. Oh, now we all know what happened here. John got shot, and look, I don't think this would have got to number one under its own steam, because it's just not. If you look at the stuff that was getting a number one at that time, it's a very varied box, you know. I mean, we've got Boney M, we've got Suicide Is Painless, I think, MASH, One Day at a Time, Sweet Jesus, I Don't Like Mondays, the Boomtown Rats, Another Brick in the Wall, Pink Floyd. It was all over the place, plus The Jam and Blondie. The charts, they were very mixed up about that time, but I still don't think this deserved to be at number one. Obviously, under the circumstances, yes, it did deserve to be number one, but I don't think it would have been strong enough to have made it by itself. And we know it was going down the UK charts, and then he got shot and it went straight up again. Sad, but that's what history does, you know. It's a bitch. Imagine what a tragedy that it had to get to number one in this situation. I mean, I don't know what John was doing during the 70s to release his records so badly. I mean, this would have been a number one smash if it had been released at the right time in Britain, in America. It wasn't. It wasn't. That's the, you know. But, you know, what can I say about it? This is the song that will go on forever.
It's a 10 out of 10.
Woman. I don't know, do you know, it's tricky. If John hadn't been shot, it's another tricky one. It got number one in England, but didn't reach the top in America. It's, I like it as a song. My wife, maybe she loves it as well, but I mean, what I don't like about it is obviously about Yoko. So it takes it away from the bigger, you know, Lady in Red and stuff like that. You could apply it to anybody in a red dress, couldn't you? And that's why it's been so successful. We imagine with Woman, it's different because you know that he's just like brown nosing around Yoko again. It's all a bit pathetic, and you sort of, you know, oh, are you going to write anything about me, John? Oh, are you going to tell the world how much you love me? You know, all this bullshit, and you know, it sort of takes away. I don't know if it would have got the number one. It's just. Ebony and Ivory. Oh. Should it have got the number one? Yeah, of course. Is that bad? Is that bad? Why not? Say. Now, I fucking hate this song. It's just shit. I don't know what it's about. I haven't got a clue what it's about. I don't want to know what it's about. I think the way how he was trying to jump on the bandwagon of Jackson at the time was pretty pathetic. And looking back on it, it's even worse when you know the full story about all that. Just wait until McCartney dies and you'll see how in with Michael Jackson he was.
What do you say? Do you say? Will the human race be run in a day?
Pipes of Peace. Now another one that got, I mean, Say got the number one because of the video, obviously. And also, Pipes of Peace did the same thing. It's supposed to be a Christmas song, but it got the number one about a month later. It's about my birthday. It was number one, I think. I don't like it very much. It's doo-dick, doo-dick. Honestly, it's like something you'd get in a primary school where music teacher's lesson. Doo-dick, doo-dick. Honestly, I don't like it. Another unworthy one. And I'm sad to say, the final song is Got My Mind Set On You. Ruby Murray or something. Ruby Murray, I Want A Curry. I don't know, some bird done it back in the 60s. A lot of people don't know that it's been done before, but it's a popular one. I mean, I remember a lot of people who you wouldn't have thought either like the Beatles, like the solo Beatles or anything. They still like it, and it's still on the playlist. Probably an undeserved win for them. I don't think it's worthy, really. I think it's a bit of a cheat, but it's a catchy song.
I find myself in times of trouble. Mother Mary comes to me. Life goes on day after day.
From that, we've got these three songs, Ferry Aid, Let It Be. Ferry Across the Mersey, that was 1989, I think. Fairy Aid was alright, so the three charity songs, which I'm not going to dwell on too much, they all involve Paul McCartney. They all got the number one. Let It Be with Fairy Aid, he sings a line. That's it.
You have stolen my dreams, my childhood.
Ferry Across the Mersey,
empty words.
The Hillsborough Disaster. That was 1989. And he sings the first line, I think. And then there's one he got number one with called He Ain't Heavy, He's My Brother. And I don't know the name of the group, but he's on there and you can't even hear him singing. But apparently on the video he does this sort of mimey guitar bit, whether he's actually playing it or not. He don't really count, to be honest with you. And well, that's rounded it all up, and I'm sorry if I've upset anyone, but tough shit.
Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape!